Yes, Father. You are Father, we adore you. We give you all the praise. We give you all the adoration. Thank you, Lord, for your glory. Thank you, God, for your blessing. You are welcome, O Lord. Come and take your place. Praise our Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise our God.
Amen.
Are you happy to be here?
Yes.
Are you happy to be in the presence of the Most High God?
Amen.
If you're happy, can you shout hallelujah?
Hallelujah!
Can you shout hallelujah?
Hallelujah!
It's great to see you guys here once more again. We're not wasting your time, especially those on social media. I would like for you guys all to please join me. Welcome the pastor, the mayor of the hour. Thank you.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Can you read this?
I have a natural voice.
Amen. 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 Good.
Father, we thank you for this evening service. You took us out into our wonderland and you brought us back to continue. Lord, we give you all the glory, we give you all the thanks. We give you all the adoration. We ask, O God, that in this evening service, your name will be glorified and magnified. Even as I finalize this topic, hear it from the mouth of the Lord, in Jesus' name. Amen. I believe I did good exposition in the morning. And because I did good exposition, can somebody help us at the children's section, please? Praise the Lord. Praise the name of Jesus. Because I did good exposition in the morning, I just want to go straight because I have a lot of things to share in this concluding part of this message. But first of all, I want us to go to Isaiah. Isaiah chapter 30 verse 29. Isaiah 30 verse 29.
Now read.
Yes.
Isaiah chapter 30 verse 29. Ye shall have a song as in the night when the holy solemnity is kept and gladness of heart. As when one goeth with a pipe to come into the mountain of the Lord.
Now listen to the different versions that I have. King James, ye shall have a song in the night when a holy solemnity is kept. What's that? Let's get another version. You will have a song as in the night when a holy feast is kept, and you will be glad in heart as when they go with music of the pipe to the mountain of the Lord, the rock of Israel. Now, church, do you understand what this place is talking about? He said, you will not struggle to be happy. You will not struggle to live a life of joy. You will never ever struggle to, you know, I keep on saying it. Keep on, if you are under a leadership that is always asking you to endure, have faith, endure, without God giving you an inner strength, putting forth some miracles. The miracle I got on Friday, it was like God adding joy to my soul because of the battles ahead. I don't know what I'm making sense. He himself, it is the work of God to give you the ability to withstand challenges, to be happy in times of trouble, to be happy in times of challenges. He said, look at it. As in the night when a holy feast is kept, your life will, you will get the strength in the midst of challenges, in the midst of battle, when others are crying, you will just be laughing. As if you just kept your faithfulness, as if it is by your mind, as if you have a machine or something reproducing the joy in you. That's what the Bible is talking about. But actually, it's not like that. But actually, it's not like that. But God is talking about somebody that have attained the level of father in Christianity. I told you in the morning. Level of children, level of young men, and level of a father. And that level of a father, you are no more afraid of death. Not because you have seen death and conquered death. No. But because God has given you his own spirit. It's not more by mind, not by power, but by the spirit of the living God. You have so much shown him faithfulness. You have so much passed through your wilderness without compromising that God has trusted you and moved you into Canaan. That's another level. Another three. I told you three levels. Egypt, wilderness, and what? Canaan. Slave, servant, and son. Three levels. Commitment, availability, accountability, ability. The third one is God. If you enter, God will immediately look at what happens. When you are in Egypt, God is there with you. When you are in your wilderness, God is there with you. When you are in your Canaan, God is no more there with you. You know why? He has given you everything. He's not judging you. He's waiting for you on the last day. He trusts you. You can never be qualified to enter your Canaan until you become a son, until God sees you as a son. If you are still a slave, no. If you are still a son, a servant, no. You will marrow in the wilderness until you become a son. As many that believe in, to them he gave power to become sons. When you become a son, you are exactly like him. That's the way he sees you. And he goes back, I'm not watching you. That's what I'm teaching. You can never enjoy this third level. You can never find yourself in this last level, the fifth level, a lifestyle of praise and worship. Because that's the only way you can maintain hearing from the mouth of the Lord. And I told you, the only key to maintain this is called faith. Without faith, it's impossible to please God. Without faith, you cannot enjoy the lifestyle of praise and worship, which is the fifth step towards hearing from the mouth of Jehovah. The first step, you have to be below a pillar in the church. The second step, you have to live a life of praying and fasting, dedicated life of praying and fasting. The third level, you discover your assignment. The fourth level. And if you get to this fourth level, you have the right company, and God sees you multiplying people, transforming the life of many, moving with the right set of people. God says he's qualified. And you know, when you are giving this kind of praise, you are talking about, you attract God. I want to tell you something. Praise is more powerful than prayer. But praise cannot retain God in you. Praise can bring God down, no doubt. Prayer is controlled by what, you know, angels are in charge of the world. Forever, O God, that word is settled in heaven. Forever, O God, that word is settled in heaven. Forever, O God, that word is... What does that mean? Angels have been given instruction. If Pastor Joseph do this, do that. if Giovanni did this, do that. If the Bible said the angels are waiting for you, Moses said, God said, go, I will send you an angel. He said, no, I understand. We are stubborn people. We will, if we, angel cannot change. Go with us, Lord, otherwise you will finish us on the road. Angels will finish us on the road. Amen. Now, when you start living this kind of a lifestyle, do you know what happens? When you are singing, let's go to Zephaniah. Somebody read Zephaniah for me. 3:17. Zephaniah 3:17. Shabba.
Zephaniah 3:17.
Yes.
The Lord thy God in the midst of thee is mighty.
No. The Lord thy God in the midst of thee is mighty. Continue.
He will save. He will rejoice over thee with joy. He will rest in his love. He will joy over thee with singing. Continue.
The Lord thy God in thy midst is what? Mighty. He will do what?
Save.
And he will rejoice over thee. Listen, listen. Do you know when you start living such life, what happens in your life? Anytime you are living a life of praise and worship, you bring God down. He said he'll come. Hallelujah. For he inhabits in the praises of his people. He inhabits in the praises of his people. He inhabits in the praises of his people. If you live such life, imagine when God enters. Darkness is against. Amen. But that's a level. He will give you the ability to be happy. He will give you the ability no matter the challenge. Look at David. David was in that level. When he saw Goliath, he didn't shed, he was happy. The first time I read the Bible from cover to cover, I came to Philippians, chapter 1. I started reading about Paul. Paul said, wow. When I came to the prison, I saw bishops. I saw archbishops. I saw apostles. I saw the men that taught me the word of God. But immediately they were in prison, they said, God is a wicked God. They stopped preaching. Philippians chapter 1, read from verse 12. But he said, when I entered the prison, all of them started preaching at them. Because they saw my lifestyle. Though I was in prison, but my mouth was not in prison. Though I was in prison, my joy was not in prison. Are you getting the point? Why? Because this is a man that God is helping. Am I making sense? You have to get to that level. Otherwise, you struggle in your Christianity. Isaiah 36, verse 27. He said, I will put my spirit upon you and cause you to do my will. He didn't say, and you will not do my will. He said, immediately I put my spirit, the purpose of putting my spirit, my own spirit, joy of the Holy Ghost, my own spirit, my own anointing. The reason is so that in trouble you will be happy. In challenges you will be happy. In every situation. I just want to lay this foundation. If you read the book of Ecclesiastes chapter 12, from verse 12 to 13, can you read it? Ecclesiastes 12, from verse 12 to 13. I'll show you scriptures. No. So that when I'm finished, when you finish this topic, you will start craving for that level. Level where God will give you his ability. But that level will not come until God sees availability in you, until God sees accountability in you, then he will give you ability. Yes. Yes.
And further,
uh-huh.
By these, my son,
mm-hmm.
be admonished of making many books. There is no end. And much study is the weariness of the flesh.
In much study, do you know what this man was saying? Do you know Solomon? Jesus said, the one, the only one greater than Solomon is here. You know who was talking about there? Jesus is there. See, this man, a man that he's not talking about, he said, among 1,000 women, I've not found any good woman. Solomon said it. But among 1,000 men, I've only found one good man. Let me, by revelation, there's a scripture that says in Proverbs chapter 11, verse 11, it says, what takes you 100 years of you? The mouth of the wicked can destroy it in 1 second. Hear this. You need 1,000 good men to be a success. But how are you going to find them? How are you going to locate them? But you only need one enemy, one wicked person to destroy whatever you do. See how easy it is? In your journey of life, I want to be a great man. I want to be a success. Because you cannot do it alone. You cannot succeed alone. The same way you cannot fail alone. There must be an agreement to your failure. There must be an agreement to your success. But in godly success, in greatness and in mightiness, if you want to be mighty, if you want to be a man that is going to affect his generation, you need more than 1,000 good people from the day you were born to be helping you, to be helping you, to be building your life. At every stage, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, if you have succeeded, if you have come to a level of success, know that you have already had almost 300 to 500 good people that have helped you in your destiny. But do you know you will be building this? 10 years, 20 years, in your 50th year, one person can destroy what you have built in 1,000. Solomon said, among 1,000 women, none is good. Do you know the man talking about? How many wives did he have? Huh? He had 700 wives. And how many concubines? 300. 300 for 700, how many? A man that married one that had 1,000 women. Was he lying? He was talking from the spirit. He said, among the 1,000, no. And look at Solomon is telling us by experience. Yes. Some people, their vision in life is to jump from one woman to another one. You know, some pastors. Let me leave. I've had somebody call me, but I thought he was a good Christian. But his vision to come to overseas to jump from one woman to another. I said, as you see me here, I've lived in Malaysia. I lived in Malaysia 7 years. I lived in Australia. It's not 7 years. I have not seen pant. Or you both said pant. I'm not interested. What shall it profit the man? What is it? There's nothing here. Solomon said 1,000 among 1,000. He said, unless you want to try 1,001 or 1,000, before you get to 1,000, trying 1,000 women to get one that will help you.
You started using stick 99 years old. Solomon said, don't waste your time thinking that woman business, Liberia would call it a woman. Your woman. Woman business cannot help you. But some people, and this man is saying, stop wasting yourself. Don't waste your time thinking you can create something new. You will read. He said the whole thing you need is in the Bible. Seeking for knowledge is foolishness outside of it. Read it, you see it. Verse 12, read it again.
Amen.
You don't need microphone, I've told you before.
Amen. And further,
yeah.
By these, my son, be admonished.
Be admonished.
Of making many books.
Stop all those nonsense. There's only one book needed, the Bible. Continue.
There is no end.
There is no end.
And much study is weariness of the flesh.
Try to invent yourself, you are destroying yourself.
Verse 13. Let us hear the conclusion.
This is what I want you to understand. This is my final word to you.
Of the whole matter.
Of the whole matter. Whether marriage, whether this, whether that, whether hearing from the Lord, whether all. The conclusion of the whole matter is what?
Fear God and keep his commandments. For this is the whole duty of man.
If there's nothing that blesses me about Dr. Miles Morrow, Dr. Miles Morrow suffered where I would have suffered. Dr. Miles Morrow studied, he said he studied Greek. He studied Hebrew. He did theology to where